Hello students, very good morning. So in the last class we completed the binomial theorem. So in this class we'll start the next chapter, that is the statistics. So from this chapter in CET we'll expect one question, and also in case of mains there will be one question given from this chapter. So in this chapter statistics we are going to study about the analysis and interpretation of data. We are going to study about the analysis and interpretation of data. So first we'll see what is data, then we'll see how to analyze and interpret that given data. So data means it is nothing but the information collected about some organization or about some person or maybe about some place. So this is the information collected about something. Now this information, the data, it is again divided into two types. So the data can be of two types. One is ungrouped data. Another is group data. Ungrouped data and then group data. So first we see what is the ungrouped data. So ungrouped data, it is the raw data or the raw information collected from the source. Okay. So directly we list the given source. So that is what ungrouped data. Suppose if I take the marks of students in a class. So we'll collect all the marks of the students and we keep it. So it is the ungrouped data. So it is usually divided by x1, x2, x3 and so on up to xn. So the raw data collected from the source, it is the ungrouped data. Next, grouped data. Now this raw data we arrange in some particular order, so which is called as a group data. Okay. So this is another type of data. So here I am taking the marks of students in a class. Let us take the marks as, suppose we are taking the marks of 10 students. If the marks are, we are getting like this. Out of 25 in a given test, one student scored suppose 23, another student scored 27, sorry, 7, 18, 22, 12, 24, 23, 3, 18, 21. So this is the marks of 10 students in a class. Now here we are not arranging this data. So this is the ungrouped data. So the raw data collected from the source. This is ungrouped data. Next, we can group this for forming a group data. Now in this group data, again is divided into two types. One is the discrete frequency. Discrete frequency data. Another is the continuous frequency data. One is discrete frequency data, another is continuous frequency data. Now in this discrete frequency data, so what we do is we write the observation and we write its frequency, means how many times it is repeating. Okay, so write the observation and its frequency, how many times it is repeating. Next, in case of continuous frequency data, so what we do is we divide this observations into class intervals. Okay, so in that class interval, how many observations are present? Now that we take it as frequency. Okay, now observe this example. So this is ungrouped data. Now we can group this into two types, discrete frequency and then continuous frequency. Now in case of discrete frequency here, what we do is we write the observation and we write its frequency. So here we write the observation and here we write its frequency. Now if we observe the data or observation 23, how many times it is appearing? It is appearing 2 times, so its frequency is 2. Next, 7, it is appearing only 1 time, so its frequency is 1. Next, 18, now this observation appearing 2 times, so its frequency is 2. Next, 22, it is appearing 1 time. 12, 1 time. 24, 1 time. Next, 3, 1 time. And then last, 21, it is appearing 1. So we are grouping this data into discrete frequency observations or data. Okay, so this is one method of grouping. Now we have another type, it is continuous frequency data. So here what we do is these observations are divided into class intervals and we write that frequency. So how many observations are present in that given class interval? Now see here, I will group this into class interval. And then frequency. Now that class interval we may divide into any number of class intervals. So here I will divide this as 0 to 5, 5 to 10, 10 to 15, 15 to 20, and then 20 to 25. Okay. So you may divide into 0 to 10, 10 to 20. Next, 20 to 30, like this. So depending on the observations given, so we can divide the class interval. Now see, in 0 to 5, how many observations are present? You can see from 0 to 5, only one observation is present, so its frequency is 1. 5 to 10, we have again one observation. Next, 10 to 15, 10 to 15 we have 12. So again only one observation. 15 to 20, 15 to 20, we have 2 observations. Next, 20 to 25, so we have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 observations. So this is the another method of grouping the data. So this is about the data. So information collected from the source is the data. It is of two types, ungrouped and then grouped. In ungrouped, directly we list all the information that we collected, which is raw data. Now we can group that raw data into two types. One is discrete frequency and then continuous frequency. So this is about the data. Now after writing about the data, okay? Now how to analyze it? Analyze means, suppose if I take the marks of this students, so this is the individual marks. If I want the performance of total class, okay, I am not asking about a particular student. What I need is, I need the performance of the total section. So how to find what is the performance of the total section? Is it good or bad or very good or very bad? Now for that we have to determine some values. Okay, so that values we can study in the measures of central tendency. Okay, so based on the measures of central tendency, we can analyze the performance of the students. Okay, so here we study about the measures of central tendency. Measures of central tendency. Okay, so as I discussed, to analyze the data, So we need to study about this measures of central tendency. So here we study three types of measures of central tendency. One is mean. First one is mean. So here mean means we study about three types. One is the arithmetic mean, next geometric mean, and then harmonic mean. Okay, so three types of mean we study, and more will be studying about the arithmetic mean. Okay, so if nothing is given means only mean is mentioned, so it means arithmetic mean. So that will be used more. Second one, median, and third one is mode. So these are the three measures of central tendency will be studied. Now in this, the first one, that is mean, it is the mathematical average. Okay, mean is the mathematical average, whereas the next two, that is median and mode, these two are the positional averages. These are the positional averages, whereas mean is the mathematical average. Okay. So now let us discuss about these measures of central tendency in case of ungrouped data and then grouped data. So first we see in ungrouped data. In case of ungrouped data, how to find these measures of central tendency? Okay, so in ungrouped data, the observations will be given. So there will be given observations like x1, x2, x3, and so up to xn. So these n observations are given. Now for these observations, how to find the mean, median, and mode? So that is what we are going to see now. Now see, first one, it is the mean. So mean is denoted by x bar, or also denoted as mu, or it is also written as E of x, means expectation of x. Okay, so mean is also called as expectation of x. So these are the three notations for mean, and it is defined as x bar equal to sigma xi divided by n. Okay, so we take the sum of observations divided by the number of observations. This is the mean of this ungrouped data. This is also called as arithmetic mean. Okay, as I told, nothing is given means it is arithmetic mean. So this is a formula for finding mean. Next, median, it is denoted by capital M. So median in case of ungrouped data, so what we do is, this observation is given, we have to arrange it either in ascending order or descending order. So arrange data. In ascending or descending order, now after arranging the data either in ascending or descending order, now the observation which is present in the middle of the data is called as median. Okay, after arranging in the ascending or descending order, now the observation which is present in the middle of the data, it is called as the median of this total data. Now how to find that which observation is present in the middle of data? So what we do is, we list all and see, we can see that which one is present in the middle of the data. Now sometimes depending on number of observations, we may get only one middle term, or sometimes we can get two middle terms. That depends on n. So if the number of observations n is odd, if n is odd, means there will be only one middle term, and that middle term is itself the median of given data. So in this art we get only one median, and the median is given by n plus 1 by truth observation. Okay, so number of observations are, we get only one median term, so that is n plus 1 by truth term is the median of given data. Now if n is even, if the number of observations is even, then there will be two middle terms. Now two middle terms, how to take the median out of the two, which one will be median? Okay, so when there are two middle terms, what we do is, for finding the median, we will take the average of the two middle terms. So when n is even, then median is given by the average of the two middle terms, that is n by 2 term and n by 2 plus 1 term. So we will take the average of these two, that is called as the median of this data. Okay, whenever n is even, so this is the median of given data. Next, we study about mode. Third one is mode. Now mode is nothing but out of the observations given, x1, x2, x3 up to xn. Now the observation which is repeating more number of times, it is called as mode of the data. Okay, so mode means the observation which repeats more number of times, it is called as mode of the given. So this is the measures of central tendency we study in case of ungrouped data. Okay, now let us see grouped data. And in group data, we studied about two types. First, we take the discrete frequency data. So, in case of this discrete frequency data, how to find the mean, median, and the mode? Now, first, let us see in discrete frequency data what will be given. So, here given the observations will be given, or data is given, and their frequency will be given, as we have seen in that example. So here observations are given like x1, x2 up to xn, and at what frequency they are appearing, that is the frequency will be given, suppose f1, f2 and so on up to fn. Okay, so in discrete frequency data, observations are given and their frequency is given. So we know x1, x2, x3 up to xn and f1, f2, f3 up to fn. Now using this, how to find its mean, median and mode? Now see first one, mean. So it is all based on formulas. Okay, you have to remember this formulas. So mean is given by x bar, it is sigma xi into fi divided by sigma fi. Formula for mean, sigma xi into fi divided by sigma fi means the sum of product of observations and their frequencies. So we have multiply x1 f1, x2 f2, x3 f3 and so on, xn fn, and take their sum, that is what sigma xi into fi divided by sigma fi. So this is the mean formula. Next, median. So in case of discrete frequency data, for finding the median, so what we do is, we have to arrange these observations in ascending order or descending order. Okay, so here also we have to arrange these observations either in ascending or descending order. That is one thing. Arrange data in ascending descending order. And then you have to find the cumulative frequencies. So cumulative frequencies means you have to add these frequencies. Okay. So cumulative frequencies means you have to keep on adding the frequencies. So here we have F1, next we have F1 plus F2. Next we have F1 plus F2 plus F3 and so on. F1 plus F2 plus up to Fn. This is called the cumulative frequencies. Okay. So for finding the median, we use another column which is cumulative frequencies. And here we denote the n, which is the sum of all the frequencies. Okay. N is denoted by sigma Fi, that is the sum of frequencies. Now median is defined as the observation whose cumulative frequency equal to n by 2 or just more than n by 2. Okay, we take the mean as median as in this cumulative frequencies. So the observation which corresponds to the cumulative frequency equal to n by 2 or just more than n by 2. So you have to find the value n by 2 and see in this cumulative frequencies where we have equal to n by 2 or just more than n by 2. Now that observation corresponds to the median of given data. So this is the method of finding the median. Next, mode. So third one, for finding the mode, okay, in case of this group data, so we will be using the formula. Mode is given by 3 median minus 2 mean. So important formula. Mode is given by 3 median minus 2 mean. So using this formula we can find the mode. Okay. So median will be given, mean will be given, then we can find the mode of the data. Okay. So this formula will be used for finding the mode. So this is in case of discrete frequency data. How to find its mean, median, and then mode. Okay. So next, in case of continuous frequency data, we'll see how to find the measures of central tendency. So in continuous frequency data, so as we studied them, the observations or the data is divided into some class intervals like this. I'll give some example. So this is the class interval and their corresponding frequencies will be given. So the class interval may be divided like this: 0 to 10, 10 to 20, 20 to 30, and so on. Here I am taking the division of 0 to 10, 10 to 20, 20 to 30 like this. Or sometimes I made it from 0 to 5, 5 to 10. So it can be any class interval. So for example, I am taking like this. And then corresponding frequencies are given. So it is F1, F2, F3 and so on. Okay. So in this class interval, now we need to find the measures of central tendency. For finding the measures of central tendency, we need the observations. But here we can see that the observations are present in between 0 to 10. Okay? So we don't know which observation it is. So in such case, what we assume is, we will assume that the data or observation is present in the middle of this class interval. Okay? So that assumption we have to make for every type of this process. So assume that the observation is present in the middle of the class interval. Means here observation we take as, now we have to assume that the observation is midpoint of this means 5. Here midpoint is 15, next 25 and so on. So this observation is given by xi, frequencies are f. So now we have observations and we have the frequencies. Now it is similar to discrete frequency data. So now we can find what is the mean, median and mode. So again, mean is here. It is sigma xi into fi divided by sigma fi, because we have the observations xi and their frequencies fi. So apply the same formula, then we will get the mean of continuous frequency data. But there is some different formula for finding the median in case of this continuous frequency data. So for finding the median, we'll be using a different formula. Okay. So for that, what you have to do is you have to write one more column, which is the cumulative frequency. Okay. So we keep on adding these frequencies f1, f1 plus f2, f1 plus f2 plus f3, and so on. In the last one, we get f1 plus f2 plus and so on up to fn. So this is one more column we write, cumulative frequency for finding the median of given data. Now here what we do is, we have to find the value n by 2. Okay? So first we have to define what is the median class. We have to find the median class. Now for finding the median class, we have to use the value n by 2, where n is the sum of all the frequencies, that already we know the rotation. So find the value n by 2. Now the median class is defined as, in this cumulative frequencies, we have to observe the cumulative frequency equal to n by 2 or just more than n by 2. So the class interval corresponding to whose cumulative frequency is equal to n by 2 or just more than n by 2. Now that class interval is considered as the median class. So first you have to select the median class. For example, we are getting n by 2 value and it is appearing f1 plus f2 plus f3. Okay, equal to n by 2, or if not equal, it may be just more than n by 2. So cumulative frequency equal to n by 2 or just more than n by 2. Now that class is considered as the median class. So first you have to identify this median class for finding the median of given data. Now after identifying the median class, now we can find the median using the formula. Then median is given by, it is L plus n by 2 minus c divided by f into h. Median is given by L plus n by 2 minus c divided by f into h. Now here L is the lower limit of median class. L is the lower limit of median class. Suppose median class we are getting like this, cumulative frequency equal to n by 2 or just more than n by 2. Now in this median class, L is the lower limit of median class. So 20 is the lower limit of the median class. Next, n by 2, we know n is the sum of all frequencies, so n is known. Next, c. Here c is the cumulative frequency. Cumulative frequency just preceding median class. C indicates the cumulative frequency just preceding the median class. This is the median class. Now just before this, we have the cumulative frequency f1 plus f2. This is taken as a C. Okay? So C indicates the cumulative frequency just preceding the median class, that is C. Next, F is the frequency of median class. F is the frequency of median class. What is the frequency of this median class? In this case, it is F3. Then H is the width of class level. H is the width of the class level. So in this case, the width of any class level we take is 10. Okay. So usually we divide the class level in such a way that that width is same for all these intervals. Okay. So we don't take different widths for this class level. So that's why we are dividing the things. So H indicates width of the class interval. Substitute all these values, simplify. Then we will get the median of these observations. Okay. So this is mean and then median. Now mode is same. So mode is given by 3 median minus the 2 mean. Okay. So this is the measures of central tendency per in case of continuous frequency data. Okay. Next, study about the measures of dispersion. Okay. So after studying the measures of central tendency, I will see measures of dispersion. So here we will be studying about the first one is range. Second one is mean deviation. And third one is standard deviation. So these are the three types of dispersion will be studied. Okay. So first one is range. Now again, which type of data will be given? So for ungrouped data we have one type of formulas, and for grouped data we have another type of formulas. Okay. So first we see in case of ungrouped data. In the case of ungrouped data. So in case of ungrouped data, the range is given by the difference between the maximum observation and then minimum observation. Okay. So the difference between greatest observation and the smallest observation is called as range. Okay. So this will not be used more. I will be mainly studying about the mean deviation and then standard deviation. So range is nothing but just we take the difference between the greatest observation and then smallest observation, that is called range. Okay. Now we will say about what is mean deviation and then standard deviation. So mean deviation, in case of ungrouped data, so we know the observations are given x1, x2, x3, x1 up to xn, observations are given. Now we see mean deviation. So here the mean deviation, it is generated by md. Okay, mean deviation, MD. Now this mean deviation we can find about maybe mean, or we can find mean deviation about the median, or we can find mean deviation about the mode. Okay, so about any of these three measures of central tendency, we can find the deviation. Okay, so first we find the mean deviation about the mean. It is divided by MD of x bar. We know x bar is the mean. So mean deviation about the mean is divided by modulus of sigma modulus of xi minus x bar divided by n. Okay. So mean deviation about the mean is sigma modulus of xi minus x bar divided by n. Not only mean deviation about mean, we can find mean deviation about the median also. If I want to find the mean deviation about the median, that is capital M. Again, we have formula sigma modulus of xi minus m divided by n. Okay? See, because already we know how to find the mean x bar and we know how to find the median in case of ungrouped data. So if you want to find its deviation, so for that we'll be using this formulas. Okay. So mean deviation about mean, mean deviation about median. If you want to find the mean deviation about mode, then we take sigma modulus of xi minus mode value divided by n. So this is the formula. In case of ungrouped data, we want to find the mean deviation, maybe about the mean or median. Okay. Next. Let's see how to find the standard deviation. Standard deviation in case of ungrouped data. Now, before studying the standard deviation, I first have to define the variance. Standard deviation is denoted by sigma, whereas the variance is denoted by sigma squared. And the variance of data, it is defined as, it is sigma xi minus x bar whole square divided by n. Okay, the variance of ungrouped data is given by the formula sigma xi minus x bar whole square divided by n. It is called as the variance which is generated by sigma square. Now sometimes the expansion of this difference square and finding summation will be complex. Now in such case we have another formula for variance. It is also written as simplified form of this. It is sigma xi squared by n minus x bar whole square. So variance is defined as sigma xi square by n, so sum of squares of the observations divided by n, minus x bar square means mean square. So using this formula we find the variance. Now using variance we can find the standard deviation. Now the standard deviation sigma, it is defined as the positive square root of variance. Is the positive square root of variance. It is called as a standard deviation. So square root of sigma means it is square root of variance. It is sigma xi squared by n minus x bar square. Okay. So this is the formula for finding standard deviation in case of ungrouped data. Okay. So everything is based on formulas. So depending on which type of data given, you have to